It takes a team to make a change. We need to be the voice to make that change.
Teens and elders against mistreating.
What is elder abuse?
Elder abuse is something someone does to a person or fails to do to a person.
Telephone scams, unfortunately, are coming around now, and seniors, sometimes they feel lonely and they welcome the way to be able to talk to someone, but must be very careful that if they don't know who is calling or if they ask questions about your house, about who is there, put the telephone down quickly so that the caller doesn't have no time to get any information about you.
How can we make
a difference?
I'm wearing purple to show my support for elder abuse.
For seniors that are mistreated, I would say that if they can listen to our message today, they should feel free to make people aware of what's happening, and somebody will do something about it, because being afraid or thinking that nobody will do anything about it, it's a detrimental thing. It's not good. You have to put it out in the light, and there will be somebody that will try to correct it.
Get rid of elder abuse, but we can definitely prevent it by educating the public, educating youth on tips and on signs to look for, and to not be afraid. If you suspect anything, there are organizations out there that will help, and all you have to do is make that phone call.
First of all, I think young people themselves, they should start conversation within their own groups. I think if they start to deepen the conversation rather than their regular small talk, they recognize the importance of seniors in the community, and from there they can go into such service projects such as visiting the seniors, playing a game of chess with them, or even within their own school communities. I'm sure there are multiple service groups and service projects that they can attend to. And even just taking part in those groups within themselves as youth, they work together, and then they show the elderly, even if it's not direct, contact speaking or such sort, even, just maybe sharing a video or writing a piece of text, sending a letter to them, showing that they're there to give their support and that they care about elderly, because I think one of the major issues is that they're neglected and they're not given the attention that they deserve.
They get involved in the elders, it will help to spread the whole subject in a wider way, at their school, at their church, with their friends. They can say, oh, I know this guy here, but he's got this problem, but nobody looks after him. So somebody will come if they get to know about it.
In my work in volunteering with TEAM, what I do to prevent elder abuse with seniors is I engage them in an activity, I engage them in conversation. I want to make sure that they feel as if they're wanted. They feel as if someone is there to talk to them, and they feel as if, they're not alone, and to prevent social isolation and social anxiety.
They have contributed so much to our community and to our culture that I feel like when they reach a certain age, us youth and us teenagers, or even young adults, we kind of put them aside and we don't show them, we don't appreciate all that they have done for us. So I think even just in general, showing them the respect and paying forward, and just keeping their culture and their tradition and all they brought to us alive in the future.
I can be treated as though I've still got my wits about me, and I've still got my, as I say, I've still got my marbles. I haven't lost my marbles just because I cannot walk properly and I've got old. I'm still with it and still got brains and what have you. And that's something young people don't seem to realize. Seniors still have their marbles, still have their thinking skills, and some of the people here are quite bright, very bright, and still know quite a lot of things.
It's important for us to work together as a team to make a change.
It's important that the young people take out this message and diffuse it to their schools and to their friends and to whoever wants, because this is a preamble of what is coming. We're all going to get old.
In my work in volunteering through TEAM, the way I prevent or educate for elder abuse is I get elders involved in recreation activities and conversation so that they feel as if they're wanted. They feel as if someone wants to hear their stories. They feel as if they're not having social anxiety or isolation from the public or from other older adults, and engage them in something that they enjoy to do and make them feel happy and make them feel wanted.
Our message to seniors.
I love Mama because she gives me hugs.
My grandparents are important to me because I learn lots of life lessons from the stories that they share, and I learn how to respect and care for others.
My nonna is really special because when I come over to her house, she always lets me help her cook, and she always tries to teach me new recipes. And when the entire family comes over for special occasions, whether it's Christmas or New Year's Eve, she always makes a big dinner for everyone. And then my nonno, he always teaches me about the garden, and he's really funny, and he always tries to make everyone laugh.
I love nonno because he plays outside with me.
My grandparents are special to me because they help us and care for us and respect us.
Phenomenon. We don't stay young for that long. We only stay young for a while, and we can contribute. And then when we get old, we hopefully help. Hope that somebody will look after us in a way which is decent, and in a way that we can feel proud of ourselves, that we don't have to go and beg for a cup of coffee or beg for some assistance.
I'm a secondary citizen almost, but I've been looked after. I've been patted on the head. I've been giving a kiss on the head. So it's not like any other person who you comfort in a conversation of your age, your own gender, and such.
It's good that teens, they are to be congratulated that they come, get involved, and try to do something.
This is our grandfather. He keeps active in our community by being an advocate for older adults. He writes articles based on the issues that arise with older adults, and he just wants to make sure that people know things, people are in touch with what's going on surrounding older adults.
My nono, he encourages me to volunteer my time at the community here, like at the TEAM project.
And the more, that's why I do that, because the more they know about older people, the more they will appreciate what elder people are, they have been, and they are still here. So it's good that the youth will connect to the old people. It's very good.
Teens are great.
My parents find it a little bit hard because they don't speak English. Their English is a second language. And they find it a little bit hard, and sometimes they find that people take advantage of that because they don't understand. And I'm trying to encourage them to, hey, if you don't like something, just say that you don't like it, or if you have to do something, you don't like to do it, whatever it is the case may be, but speak up. Even though you can't speak very well English, make yourself understand and understood by the individual. Because most people here do understand. And but not only here, but even outside. I find that it's very, very hard, very challenging at times because of it. And you know, my father's 88, and he still has his mind set, and you know, he exercise and all that. He's highly diabetic. And my mom has dementia, and she's 86 years old. So she has lost, her memory is not good anymore. She's going back to the young stages of her life. She does recognize us. Sometimes she doesn't recognize my father. But yeah, it's very challenging, it really is. And I find that, you know, people sometimes they really don't care, you know, and we should really look after our elderly people because they have made a sacrifice for us, and they have paved the road for us. And so now it's time for them to be looked after. And I think that we need more to that. I think that as we age, our rights remain the same, but probably we have different needs and requirements in life because you're aging. But it doesn't mean that your rights are different. They're always the same. Since you're born, you have a right. And so therefore, I believe that even when you age, you have the same right as when you were born. They're different. The different needs, of course, because you're aging, but the rights be always the same. So these rights would include right to information, right to be able to adhere to the services that the government provides for the elderly, not only to be provided but also to be respected. Seniors' rights should include actively be able to participate in the community, be able to access the resources available to them, and to be able to be included and integrated into the community they live in. And the major thing is to be able to live and feel safe in their community that they live in.
Statistics on elder abuse.
It's actually estimated that between 4 and 10% of older adults that are Canadian have experienced elder abuse. However, this is not actually 100% accurate because not everybody experiencing this abuse reports it. So that being said, the percentage can actually be higher. And from this, we find that it's really challenging to reach out to those that do experience the abuse that don't report it because we don't know of it. So that's why we really want to ensure everyone's aware that we're here to help.
Who can we talk to about it?
Elder abuse, it's sometimes it could be a nervous reaction with parents, grandparents, and even introvertedly, people do, you know, not very nice things. You know, they shout at them and grab them.
Some advice to people who are my age would be for them to spend time with some seniors, like talk to them, maybe play a couple games with them, because a little goes a long way and it would really mean a lot to them, because some of them don't have family or they feel lonely, so if you could spend some time with them, it would just make them feel so much better.
My message to seniors who are being mistreated is they should have their own say, and they should have their own rights to what they want to do, how they want to live their life, when they want to do whatever they want to do. It's their life, they should be able to do whatever. If a senior is not living at their home or with their family should call and check on them or come visit, or even just say a quick hello to them, because it would make the senior feel like welcome and not lonely, and they would just get happy and it would help them live life to the fullest.
I don't like getting up because I cannot walk. The thing is, when I was younger, I walked every day of my life until I had to use a walker. I walked 3 miles every day. I loved it. I cannot do it now. And that is one of the things that frustrates me very much, because I cannot walk and just go and say, I'm going for a walk, I'm going to stroll. And that's very frustrating when you get older and you get problems. That's my opinion. So that's what I find. And your friends leave you too. Because I had a lot of friends. Now when you have friends and then they leave you and you're the one that's left, sort of thing. Anyway. So my advice to young people is keep your friends, make sure you make lots of friends, keep them through your life and enjoy them. You've got to think you will not be young forever. And there'll be a time when you'll be old. And you've got to think of this. I know it's very difficult when you're 18, 19, even 30 to have these thoughts, but I really think
You should think about this. I know even when I was young, I never thought that I would get old. I saw my parent, my mother getting old, but I never thought that I would get old. And you don't, and you have these friends, and you join together, like there was four of us when we were young. But now three of them have died, and I'm the one that's left. And you don't think of this when you're young. And I never thought that I would be the one that would outlive all my friends. I thought I would die before they did. So this is a problem, and I think you should also start to think about what you're going to do when you start getting older. Make sure that you have enough money, enough, you know, collateral and things like that. That's my opinion. But the trouble is that health comes into play a lot. And you think, am I always going to be healthy? No, you are not going to be healthy. Not always. There are very few people that live to be 93 who are very healthy. They've all got health problems. And that's what I think. That's my opinion, anyway, of getting older.
I've always taken pride in that I make the decisions and so on. If I can. I mean, mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes. But too many people are very willing to give up some of the choosing, and I'm not. I want to do it myself. But on the other hand, I realize that the world doesn't revolve around my belly button, that there are other people in the world. I raised my children to be the same, and I don't wish them to be catering to me. I wish to do what I can do as long as I can do it.
I believe that we should look after our elderly people because they paved the road for us, young people, young generation coming through, and they deserve our respect, and they deserve our help, because I believe that they have paid their dues already. So it's our time now to show them that we care about them and things of that nature.
I just greet each day, and that's it. The world isn't made of just today. It's a whole bunch of backwards. But I don't really have any elder abuse. Maybe because I've kept control of what's happened in the past or whatever, I don't know. But things in life you can't. There are some things in life that you really have no control over. And health is one of them. Just, you need friends. You need family, friends, and other people around. That's what the world's all about.